In this video, we're going to be discussing what you should use. Should you use Python or should you use Ruby on Rails? So these are two different technologies that many people are trying to understand which one is the best fit for their project. So maybe you're building a minimum viable product, an MVP, and you want to know what is the best technology to use to build that. So in this video, we're going to be discussing that. Before we jump into the video, make sure to hit the like button and subscribe to this channel if you enjoy this kind of content. So we're talking about whether you should use Python or Ruby on Rails. So let's begin by breaking down this question. So first of all, we've got to understand that Python is a programming language, whereas Ruby on Rails is an actual framework. So the framework that sits on top of the programming language. In most cases, if you're talking about building a website or a web application using Python, then you're probably talking about using Django. Django is one of the most popular frameworks that is built on top of the Python language. And Django is actually very similar to Ruby on Rails. So Ruby on Rails is running on top of the Ruby programming language. And if we are going to compare these two frameworks, there is actually a lot of similarities between them. So both of them use migrations in order to control the database changes. So you'll make a migration file, run that migration, and then in the future you can either roll back migrations or roll forward migrations. So it allows you to have version control on your database changes. So that's a pretty cool thing if you're trying to build a large-scale application. So having the ability to apply version control to your database schema, is something that is really important and really useful in both of these frameworks. Another similarity between both of these frameworks is that they use a MVC approach. So that's a model view controller approach. And that means that they both follow the same structure in terms of where to place your code when you're building your application. If you are used to working with Ruby on Rails, then you'll be using Ruby gems to build your application. Whereas with Django, you will have a similar concept. You will also be able to use something very similar to Ruby gems, but within Django, they call it apps. So you will add different apps to like include different functionality that has been pre-written by other developers. So that is a useful way to speed up the development process. And you can do that in both of these frameworks. In general, I would say that both of these frameworks can build really good web applications. From my experience of working with both of these frameworks, I would say that both of them serve a very similar market. They are both very good for building MVPs, so a minimum viable product. And the reason for that is that they can be used to build products really quickly. And this is because you can use gems or apps to include functionality really quickly without having to rewrite everything from scratch. So it makes it really easy to build applications in a shorter amount of time. There are a few things you may want to consider when trying to decide if you're going to use Django or Ruby on Rails. From my experience of using both of these technologies, I would say that probably the best reason to choose one over the other is really what is your team experienced with, or what is the developers that you're working with got experience in. So if your team are experienced in writing code in Ruby, for example, then Ruby on Rails would be the most logical choice for your team to use. Alternatively, if your team are more experienced in writing in Python, then Django would be the most obvious choice. So both of these frameworks are really good at building products, at building MVPs. So both of them serve this market really well. And ultimately it comes down to what is the experience in terms of the underlying language. These are my thoughts on whether you should use Python or Ruby on Rails in 2021. Let me know what you think in the comments below. And as always, thank you so much for watching this video. If you've enjoyed it, hit that like button and subscribe to the channel. And I will see you all in the next one.